Griner and Azaray Stevens to jump it up. And game three is underway. Phoenix controls the tip. Griner muscling through. Couldn't get it to go. Cunningham the offensive rebound. Griner will take and hit. She has been just money from 17 feet.
One of the things I'm looking for, Ryan, is how this game is going to be officiated. Phoenix will defend very physically.
Quigley catch, fire, and connect from three.
Looking to finish a little bit better here in game three.
Had 12 assists in that game too. Parker finishes on the inside off the delivery from Quigley.
Dangerous. Candace Parker is involved, and there's a switch.
Deegan Smith turns the corner, forces it up and in off the window.
That's got to do wonders for her confidence.
Here's Vandersloot into the teeth of the D. Oh, what footwork! And the finish from Courtney Vandersloot.
A little bit of a limp as well. And we see here just beautiful footwork by Courtney Vandersloot, finishing with the left hand. Chicago has been terrific in terms of getting...
Parker fading and hitting off the window. Signature CP3 in Chi-Town.
We know she can face up. She can have range out to three, but here one-on-one going over the right shoulder and the kiss. Yvonne, that shot all series long.
Oh, Vandersloot swings free of Diggin Smith and gets the roll. In game two, Vandersloot had her ninth career 10 assist playoff game, matching Sue Bird for most all time as Hartley steps into a three. Here's Taurasi into Griner. Griner turns, kicks, Hartley, good ball fake, and hits.
This is a different Bria Hartley than we've seen in games one and two. Kahleah Copper's been terrific on the offensive glass.
How about the handle from Hartley, but then just threw it away. Down the other end, Vandersloot bounces, Stevens finishes. She brings energy, and there are times where we need it. Copper finishes, plus the foul. Kahleah Copper roaming to the rim.
Be ready to defend Kahleah Copper every single time down the floor, making her take that shot.
Here's Quigley, leaping through, laying in. It's a 12-point Chicago lead. Phoenix has missed 16 of its last 18 shots as they now turned it over seven times. Dolson creeps in and reverses it home. Dexterous and with a smile.
Dolson surprises even herself here. All right, go under the rim, big girl. Finish with the touch. Getting to the spot on the block that she wants, and all of that you have to credit Chicago's defense.
Cunningham wide open, gets the three to drop in. Here's Copper wide open, connects on a three. It's back to 14.
She can hurt you from the inside and the out. Great screen there by Azaray Stevens. Kahleah Copper.
Oh, the movement of Chicago. Quigley on a jumper. Largest lead of the night. Back door. Quigley the deflection. Parker the no look. Copper the collect. And the finish. Plus the foul.
Draining from three. No wing does this any better in the WNBA. Running the floor. Getting the easy two. In the half court, they are just struggling to find anything easy offensively.
A 10-0 Chicago run that ends there on Taurasi's first three of the night. She scored just 2 points in the first half of game two, and then 18 the rest of the way. Copper again, bunny hops into the bucket. Thought about the three, taking Hartley, double comes, who's open? Vandersloot the lob, Parker the touch. As light as linen. It's a 20-point lead. Vaughn got it to go on the no look from Taurasi. And they have brought it tonight. Copper will take. You bet! KFC!
Diana Taurasi had to give her space because she blew by her the last time down the floor. When you give her space, she can do that as well.
18 points in this first half as Diggins Smith reigns in a three. Chicago is playing with Phoenix, an 18-point lead. They have dominated the Mercury in the first half of game three. Stevens gets the roll. Just 1 for 8 from the floor now. Copper. Oh, Copper swivels it in! A magician!
Kahleah Copper has 6'9", Brittany Griner on her, unafraid. She is so good at taking it to the other side of the rim, Holly Rowe told us.
Here's Diggins Smith, finding Turner on the roll. Pass was deflected to Griner. It was intended for the corner, and Griner flips it in.
Finally, a good look for Brittany Griner.
As it poked away by Turner, gets it into Parker. 5 to shoot. Parker fading and hitting.
Parker 6'4", her defender 6'9". So how do you create separation right there?
And remember, that game had gotten out of reach when she came in the fourth quarter. Griner catches and the soft touch. Quigley working around Parker. Parker switched on Penny, takes advantage. 10 points for Parker. Playing for her hometown team as Griner turns and finishes. It has been a much more efficient Brittany Griner here in this third quarter.
You're going to take a little bit quicker shots, but that's the pace then that Chicago wants to play.
Vandersloot the lead, Stevens the lay.
Long and active they are.
Parker will take and hit from three. Parker with 13 points. Chicago has a team 4 of 7 from downtown in this game. Griner faces up and knocks it down. Petty dumps it in. Griner the quick turn and the finish. Brittany Griner up to 14 points. She has the last 8 for the Mercury. Vandersloot wiggled by Griner into the paint, blocked by Parker, loose ball, Vandersloot got a paw on it, and here comes Chicago. Oh, Vandersloot, what a dime to dime in for 2.
Courtney Vandersloot's eyes, because they tell lies right there, Diamond to Shields. Pretty stuff. So good at moving the defense just with a look.
Griner bodies in and puts it home off the window. Taurasi has dealt with a high ankle sprain and a broken bone in her foot throughout these playoffs. Has still authored some epic moments as DeShields has been a factor tonight. Alana Smith wedges in a 3 off back iron.
It's just about staying healthy until the clock expires, Ryan.
Petty can't spin in a 3. Smith cleans it up, lays it in. We've seen incredible dedication from the Sun, moving up their preseason games. Vandersloot, 10 assists, now most all time in playoff history as Hebert hits the fall away. Normally that role would belong to Sophie Cunningham, but with the injury to Kia Nurse, a torn ACL, Cunningham slots into the starting lineup. Hebert floats in another. Evans, another. You bet! Thunderous game 3 performance from the Chicago Sky. 86-50, the final. The largest margin of victory ever in a WNBA Finals game.